What's up everybody, here is TheBoySaber and I am back with another video. So today I'm gonna finally introduce myself to you guys. I'm gonna tell you who I am, where I'm coming from, everything about myself. So I made this list so I don't go wrong and I don't mess up everything talking to you guys. So my name is Saber, I'm 34 years old and I'm from Italy. I am a disabled guy, I have been disabled since my whole life. And my disability is called spina bifida. I will put a link down below that explains everything about my disability. I have spent the first 13 years of my life in and out the hospitals. I have been through surgery at least 6 times. Doctors told my family that I will not be able to get up the wheelchair. And at the age of 4, I had the chance to prove everybody wrong. I still today remember all the details about the first time I made my first step. I remind you, I was 4 years old. I was at the neighbor's house. There was so many kids running around and playing and having fun. And I was the only one sitting on the floor, left alone, just because I wasn't able to do the same thing that every other kid was doing. So I started thinking to myself, why they can and I can't? So I remember this like it happened. Like yesterday. So I remember scrolling back. There was a wall behind me. I remember holding on that wall, standing up and going back and forth all across the room. And I remember everybody that was busy doing their stuff. Everybody stopped looking at me, looking like something magical has happened, because before that event I wasn't even able to walk. I wasn't to move, basically. It was a shock for everybody, including myself, honestly. Like, it felt like time has stopped for a minute. When the neighbor told this to my mom did not believe it, because she did not see it happening. But later that day, she had also the chance to see it. You guys imagine what happened. Besides that, between the age of 6 and 12, I was bullied at school. I was bullied very badly. I was from every kid, just because of what I was going through. The bully experience has changed me to the worst. I used to talk to everybody. I used to be very social. But after that experience, I changed completely. I became more introverted. I stopped having self-confidence. I stopped having self-esteem. I stopped having self-love. My life started going downhill. And this kept going for a very, very long time. I built a hard wall all around me that made me push everybody away from me just because I was afraid of being treated that way again. I wasn't allowing nobody in my life. I was spending most of the time by myself. But then I wanted to make a change and try to start allowing people in. And basically I was in need of somebody in my life. So in order for me to get that, I started making what I called wrong choices. I started the night style life. I started like going out and all the stuff that comes with the night lifestyle. Just because I was looking for everybody's approval. I just was looking for someone to accept me. I was tired to be alone. So I started making very wrong choices. I started having the wrong people in my life. Yeah, I was surrounded by so many people, that's true. But I realized that lifestyle, it wasn't for me. What I wanted for myself. So I was looking for something else. I discovered... Before I get to that. I was hiding my insecurities in junk food. I felt like food was my only escape from my reality. But this is the absolute worst move I have ever made. I gained weight. My self-esteem went even lower and just wasn't how I expected it to be. So then at the age of 24, I finally discovered fitness, bodybuilding, sport in general. And from that moment, my life has changed completely, 360 degrees. I started knowing myself more. I started having self-esteem. I basically was able to rebuild my self-confidence. So, I've been working out for like 10 years. And I have to tell you guys that since I started that, my life started going better and better and better. So I decided to use sport as a way to get over my insecurities, to get over my the bad side of my personality, basically. I realized that this was the best decision I have ever made in my life. Now I feel better with myself. I love myself more. I have a very high confidence. I have a very high self-confidence, even though there are some points that I'm still working on, because I'm not yet where I want to be. I'm very far away from who I used to be, and that's a very big step for someone who has went through what I went through. So I have to say that I'm very grateful and I'm very proud of myself and what I became. So I want to tell you guys, if there is anybody watching this video who's going through similar stuff as me, don't let nobody define you. Basically, don't let nobody control your life, because you are the one that should be in control of your life, and you should be the one who says, this is good for me, this is not good for me. Stop allowing other people's opinion or judgment to define you, because you are the only one who can determine whether you're good or not. If you feel inside like you're not good enough, make sure you work on yourself. Make sure you do what's best for you. Don't let nobody define you. Don't let nobody make you assume that you are not good enough, because whatever change you make, if you base it on what people think, like, you will never be good enough. So make sure you're good for yourself. Make sure to do what makes you happy and what makes you feel good with yourself. Because no matter what you do, people will always find that one thing that they don't like about you. So make sure you do what it's best for you, what makes you happy, what makes you be satisfied with yourself. So with that being said, this is it. I hope you guys like this video. Let me know in the comment below what you think. And if you have any questions, if there is anything you want to know more about me, just drop it in the comment below and I will make sure I will answer it. And don't forget, please do like, comment, and share and subscribe to this channel. And until the next time, see ya. Peace, guys. Love ya.